as well be playing in this series. You took a puck off the side of the head there last game. Almost got mixed up physically there. There's Hedman speaking of getting mixed up physically. And we've got another penalty coming up, I believe. Or not. Let's see.
You know what? I don't think they touch him. I'm going to tell you. I think he missed the puck. The referees have got to get together here. I think he just didn't catch it. Watch him reach up for it. He's going to miss it, and it catches him right in the face. Oshie never touched him. And you remember, you go back to the Boston series, a four-minute penalty was called on Pasternak for high-sticking Hedman, and he high-sticked himself. He just missed it. I know the stick is up there, and the referee sees the stick, but there's no way that he sees contact. There's just no way. That's a tough one to swallow, but they're not going to change it.
The shot pass, and that hit Orlov, then they score! Speak of the devil, one of the greatest on the power play.
Has been excellent. So the power play underway. Bozak with his shot. Ross to save. Van Riemsdyk scores. Seven seconds after the call of the penalty, the Leafs strike first. James Van Riemsdyk from his office.
It's amazing what the playoffs bring. The drama. You get a missed call. Go back to game one, a missed offside ended up costing the Leafs the game's first goal against. There's a missed call, it hits the glass, goes out. You get an opportunity to turn the game around and maybe even the series. Bozak bears down on the faceoff and then traffic in front. That's where James Van Riemsdyk has scored the majority of his goals.
Controlled off the draw, there's a shot into traffic. Puck is loose in front. Quick hand find, it goes into the corner. Iafallo lost his footing, and we got an injured king in front of the net. That is Kopitar. He is very slow to get up from behind the play.
Boy, is he ever reaching for his jaw. This is not a good sign for Andre Kopitar, who's not a guy that stays down too often. Call, they thought there should have been a penalty here as he was pushed down. It happened once he was on the ice. So here's the scrum here in front of the net. A little cross check on Haula. Haula goes down and he stays with him. And right there, it's a little flare, either an elbow or a glove that catches him in the face. I'm not sure what gets him. They thought there should have been a penalty maybe on that. It's a punch there. A little bit of a butt end by Haula into the face area of Andre Kopitar.
Slot area presence in front of Tuukka Rask.
A Boston penalty.
Marchand's going to get a high sticking penalty.
Pasternak elevates a stick of Victor Hedman. Hedman hits himself with his own stick. Pasternak's stick never made contact.
Here's Crosby working it in. Crosby down low. Wrapper out of 10. Got it out front. Horquist scores. Penguins celebrate. Referee still hasn't signaled yet.
Well, here we go. Poor controversy. The referee waved it off behind the net. Obviously, they'll have a good look at this. And Penguins are saying it's in. Hornquist gets the goal after Crosby again does the wraparound like only he can after the giveaway by the Washington Capitals at the blue line.
And then one more variable to throw in, Greg. That was close to being offside, too.
And again, look at the ref. You saw the ref come in, waving no goal. There is the play. Can you see that it's over the line? Not from that angle. The call on the ice was no goal.
Close. And I mean,
I don't know.
After video review, the call on the ice is confirmed, no goal.
Wow.
Him against Hall of Fame goaltenders.
Yes. Stanley Cup winning goaltenders.
At this time of the game, It's 9 shots to none, and then the slash, and caramba. That doesn't hit him in the hands, that hits him on the knee.
Here's Sergachev, who scored that goal for Point. Cross-ice pass, they score! Gord! Power play goal!
This is a resilient bunch, and if you're a fan of the Tampa Bay Lightning, you haven't seen Boston much, look out.
Oh, here comes Marchand! And Strawman was able to take the shot away from Brad Marchand.
All players want is the same standard from the start of the game to the finish. This is the first period, Torrey Krug on Braden Point. Kind of a nothing slash, doesn't take away a scoring opportunity. Now let's watch the third period. Anton Strawman, a slash into the hand, and look at Marchand's reaction, and then you'll see the Bruins bench. They're like, you gotta be kidding me, there's no slash there?
And, you know, we hate to harp on the refs sometimes, but tonight they deserve to get harped on because the rinky-dink ticky-tack calls that they called in the first period, like this one right here, hits the pad, doesn't even hit the stick. He gets called for a penalty, no scoring chance. I mean, how can you call that a penalty early in the game in such a big playoff game? And then in the third period, you have a chance with the most dangerous player on the ice to score a goal to tie it, and the slash is right on the hands. Watch this. Right on the hands of the most dangerous player on the ice, Marchand, right there. And that's not a slash. That is the definition of the new slashing rule. Even Marchand looked at it. Then you have a cross check by Girardi. How can none of these be called at the most crucial part of a hockey game in the playoffs? It's unacceptable. It's got to be better. It's too inconsistent. And if they don't, there's going to be a lot of complaining, not only on the ice, but all over the hockey
into the Colorado zone. Another save by Hammond. Rebound score, but it is waved off. The goal is waved off after it bounced in off Bonino, and now the officials will get together
and see if it's a kicking motion. It goes off the skate, no doubt about it, by Bonino. Good job by Ekholm to get this to the net, looking for a rebound, and watch a right skate. Now the question is that a distinct kicking motion?
After we review, the call on the ice has been reversed. We have a goal.
Wow.
And fired by Sergachev back in deep. Got to come up there with McAvoy. Turned it over. Scores! Stamkos!
It gets out into the neutral zone. McAvoy is going to pick this puck up, and as he turns the net, there goes the arm and stick from Kucherov around McAvoy. He goes down.
Inside the line. Evelyn lost his footing. It's a clear-cut break for Bufflin. Dustin Bufflin stop. Rebound chance. Score! Andrew Kopp. But we got a penalty and no goal. So it wasn't Matt Hendricks who crashed into the goaltender, and the goal's been wiped out.
Well, again, it's a turnover at the blue line by the Preds that leads to this breakaway for Bufflin. And Rene comes up with the initial save. But the cross check by Hendricks sends Emelin into Pekka Rene. Let's see if the contact is made with Rene and Emelin. And I think that that contact right there didn't allow Rene to get
that puck in. Nash out in front of Torrey Krug, who sprints into the attack. His own feeds Marchand down low. He scores! Torrey Krug with a career year, and that's just part of why. Well, Toronto's bench is watching the replays because this was close to being offside. But this is what the Bruins want. They want Krug carrying the puck until he's challenged. Does he gain the blue line? Is everybody onside? And as we wait to determine if they're going to challenge, what a pass by Krug. He's off. Right through the skates of Pollock. Tape to tape to Marchand. Great speed. Simple move to the backhand. I mean, that's a great play. It's a good power play goal. Is it close enough? Because if you challenge this, Jack, and you're wrong, Bruins go right back on the power play.
I think he's off.
They're not challenging. Whoa!